adverbs in English language are used to modify verbs or clauses in a word or sentence. And movement? Adverbs is commonly referred to the movement concept because of its nature to modify movement skills, giving in-depth description of how the skills are displayed. Different movement conception lead to the different sorts of behavior, which are mainly dictated by the stimulus offered from a task. Example, doing a strong throw to my teammates at the far end of the court, closer to the goal, or by how the individual wants the skill to be. Executed example, dancer will jump higher up to perform a triple flip. Movement concept also the outlines on how a movement is executed, with a focus of the fundamental base of the skills. It is also an idea used to modify or enrich the range and effectiveness of skill employment. As a result, this demonstrates the kid's capacity to perform movement abilities. There are the four major movement concept. First, body awareness. It represents the instrument of the action. Second, space awareness, where the body is moving. Third, is the effort awareness. It is the quality which with the movement as executed. Lastly, is a relationship awareness. It is the connection that occurs as the body moves with object, people, and the environment.
The first major movement is the body awareness. This describes the pattern of movement made by moving body parts. There are three categories in body awareness. First is the body parts. Second is the body shapes. And lastly is the body comport. Body parts. Body parts consist of head, hair, eye, nose, ear, mouth, neck, shoulder, arms, hands, stomach, back, elbow, buttock, leg, knee, foot, and heel. Body shapes. Narrow. The girl was standing narrowly, together in the same line, toes slightly apart. Wide. The legs placed wide apart, both feet facing forward, while arms are widely open. Twisted. Twisting part of your body, such as your head, shoulders, and fingers, while not moving to one place to another. All stretching activities are called twisted movement. Symmetrical. Symmetrical movements are when both hands or feet are performing the same motion. Both sides of the body are working together to perform the same motion. Asymmetrical. Asymmetrical movements are very similar to reciprocal movement, meaning both sides of the body are working together, but both sides are performing separate tasks with one side leading and the other side supporting or assisting. Round, a shape like a circle or a cylinder. Symmetrical. Symmetrical movements are when both hands and feet are performing the same motion. Both sides of the body are working together to perform the same motion. Actions of the body parts is also one of the category in body awareness. This includes the kinds of roles of the body segments that can play in the movement. Example, when badminton player waiting to receive the ball. At first, his weight is put at the center. When he saw the ball is coming to his right, he transferred his weight to his right leg, then back to the center. Same goes when he saw the ball is coming to his left. Actions of the whole body is the last category in body awareness. This is the activities that are performed by the whole body. There are three categories in action of the whole body. First is the locomotor. Second is the non-locomotor, and last is manipulative. Locomotor movement skills are those in which the body is moved in one direction or a combination of directions from one point to another. Non-locomotor movement skills are those movements that occur in the body parts or the whole body that do not cause the body to travel to another place. Manipulative movement skills are the motor skills that use hands, feet, or another body parts to move.
Second is the space awareness. Space awareness expresses the concepts of where the body can move. It has three categories: the location, directions, and levels. Location, it describes the position as to where the movement occurred. Next is the direction, describes movement occurring in different directions, like walking forward, running to the left, walking backward, running clockwise, and walking sideways. And the last category in space awareness is the level. Level, it shows how the movement was done, like high, low, and medium. Pathways, it describes the variety of pathways where the body can move, like walking in a straight pathway, walking in zigzag, and curve. Extension describes the size of the movement and the range the body needs to achieve. Small movement and large movement, far and near.
The third major movement is the effort awareness. Effort awareness expresses the concept of how the body can move in the action. The time and flow is the two categories in effort awareness. Time describes the speed of the movement occurred, slow, fast, and accelerating. Force describes the strength of force of movement occurred, movement like soft and hard. Flow describes the continuity of movement occurred, like free to bound movement. Focus, the state or quality of having or producing clear visual definition. There are two types of focus, the direct and indirect. If you want your movement to be direct, you will just directly put your hand to your front and raise it immediately, while the indirect is you will make a way to delay it.
Relationship awareness expresses the concept of with whom or with what the body moves, with object or with people. It is described movement with equipment or people, or moving around and about equipment or people. With people, it is described movement with people and our partners, like solo. Duo. Group.
Finally, we're here, so why? Saying you got a flight, need an early night. No, don't go yet.
Our contrast. Movement concepts are interrelated and displays in the various combination. In the early passes of development, teaching and coaching of fundamental movement skills includes movement concept heavily, creating more opportunities for the child to explore the basis of movement.